Greetings, welcome to Digital Switching System course. The course instructor, Asha K, Sai Vidya Institute of Technology. In the previous session, refer part 2 video, the topics covered were evolution of switching system, introduction, message switching system, circuit switching system, functions of switching system, and distribution system. In this session, the topic of discussion is basics of crossbar system. The earlier Strauger switches requires regular maintenance, and the banks needs cleaning mechanism and also lubrication. The disadvantages leads to the development of other forms of switches, namely matrix of telephone relays. The figure shows the crossbar switch with their contacts multiplied together horizontally and vertically. Since a switch with n inlets and n outlets require n square relays for its cross point, this was uneconomic for larger exchanges. Hence, a more economical solution was provided by the invention of a crossbar switch by G.A. Bettelander in 1917. For crossbar switch with n inlets and n outlets require only 2n cross points. Hence, the crossbar system was economic. The basics of crossbar system, the figure shows the matrix of cross points where we have m inlets and n outlets. The modified crossbar switching system with matrix of cross points is shown in figure 2. The mechanism of crossbar is shown in this particular figure. As shown in the figure 3, crossbar switches has vertical bars and vertical magnets. These are also called as holding magnets and holding bars. And it will be having horizontal bars and horizontal magnets. These are also called as selecting bars and selecting magnets. By energizing the horizontal bars and the vertical bars, a particular cross point can be used to establish the connection. A crossbar switch has no intelligence. Hence, marker control of a crossbar switch is necessary. As shown in the figure 4, marker control of a crossbar switch consists of resistors and marker. The marker control of a crossbar switch has horizontal bars or inlets, are also called as selecting bars, and vertical bars are called outlets and are also called as holding bars. Now, to make a connection between the cross point 3 and 6, where 3 is the inlet, holding bar or selecting magnet, 3 has to be energized, and 6 is the outlet. It means your vertical bar or hold magnet 6 has to be energized. In the marker control of the switch, it has no intelligence. The resistor and marker decides the switching path. Switching operation is because of the two magnets, namely selecting and holding magnets. In the marker control, the impulses from the subscribers are received by a resistor, which in turn passes the routing information to the marker. The marker operates the selecting magnets and then required holding magnets to complete the switching operation. The crossbar switch can make more than one connection at a time. The switch of size 10 cross 10 can make 10 simultaneous connections. The number of cross points are 2 into n, that is 2 into 10, that is equal to 20 cross points. As discussed in the diagram 4, the marker control of a crossbar switch will be having marker and a resistor. To make the connection between the inlet 3 and outlet 6, this will go to the next switching stage. Since the matrix of crossbar switch has no intelligence, marker and resistors will provide the suitable connecting path between the incoming line and the outgoing line by energizing the horizontal bars and vertical bars with the help of the horizontal magnets and the vertical magnets. The main advantages of crossbar switches are small in size, hence faster operation is possible. Since no heavy duty mechanical parts are available in crossbar switch, maintenance is easy. Crossbar switch can make more than one connection at a time, since 10 cross 10 switches will be having 10 cross 10 simultaneous connections. And automatic alternative routing is possible, that is, when the direct connection has failed, another alternative path will be accessed by the marker control device. tracing of unknown calls is easy because everything, the data will be stored in the register. And more facilities such as barring STD calls, STD stands for subscriber trunk dialing calls, reminder calls, etc. are available. Less wear and tear is also one of the advantage of the crosspar switch. Moving on to a cross point is a very small switch which provides connection to various links of speech path. The cross point has two states, open and closed. In the open state, the impedance is very high, typically 10 to 250 mega ohms. In the closed state, the impedance should be as low as possible, typically 0.1 to 200 ohms. The cross point can be an electronic device, that is, diode can be used as a cross point or a transistor can be used as a cross point. Moving on to two-stage switching network, we'll analyze the interconnection of 100 incoming lines to 100 outgoing lines. Here, the two-stage switching network consisting of primary stage and the secondary stage. Primary stage has 10 switches and secondary stage has 10 switches, and in between primary stage and secondary stage, we will be having 100 links. The 10 switches are present in primary stage and 10 switches are present in secondary stage. Total number of switches is equal to 20. Each switch is of size 10 cross 10. The interconnecting lines from primary switch to secondary switch are called as the links. The figure 5 shows the two-stage link network. As in this figure, the number of an outlet on a primary switch corresponds to the number of secondary switch to which it links goes, and the number of an inlet on a secondary switch corresponds to the number of primary switch from its links comes. For example, to understand this particular link concept, we'll consider link number 23. Link 23 corresponds to outlet of 3, outlet 3 of primary switch 2 to the inlet 2 of the secondary switch 3. Similarly, link 00 corresponds to outlet 10 of the primary switch 10 to inlet 10 of the secondary switch 10. The cross point calculations of two-stage switching network. The number of primary switches present is 10. The number of secondary switches is present is 10. The total switches in the two-stage network is 10 plus 10, that is equal to 20. The number of cross points per switch is 2 into 10, that is equal to 20. The total cross point in primary switch, that is 10 into 20, that is 200. Similarly, total cross points in secondary switch is 10 into 20, 200. The total cross point required is equal to addition of primary cross points and the secondary stage cross points, that is 200 plus 200, that is equal to 400 cross points. Concentrator is a device where more incoming trunks will be present and less outgoing trunks will be present. A concentrator for connecting 500 incoming trunks to 100 outgoing trunks is shown in figure. And here 2 to 9 switches are not shown. Primary stage is a cascade connection of switches. One switch group has 50 inlets. Such 10 switches we have, 50 into 10 is equal to 500 incoming trunks. Coming to the secondary stage, we have one switch which is of 10 inlets, and we have such 10 switches. 10 into 10 is equal to 100 outgoing trunks. The calculation of the cross point for this is, the number of primary switches is equal to 5 into 10, 50. The number of secondary switches is equal to 10. Total number of switches in the network is 50 plus 10, that is equal to 60. The total number of cross points, the number of cross points per switch is equal to 2 into n, that is 2 into n, 2 into 10, that is equal to 20. The total cross point in primary switch is equal to 50 into 20, that is 1000. And total cross point in secondary switch is equal to 10 into 20, 200. The entire network is having the number of cross points, that is addition of primary switch cross point and secondary switch cross point, that is 1000 plus 200 is equal to 1200 cross point. Moving on to 4-stage switching network for interconnecting 1000 incoming trunks to 1000 outgoing trunks with the help of 10 cross 10 switches. Here, one input frame 1 corresponds to 100 incoming lines and 100 outgoing trunks. Here, 1N10 representation is used here. We have 3 different types of links, A-link, B-link and C-link. Here, say for example, input frame is 1 wherein it is in one exchange and this will be C-link will be in another exchange. Here, we have input frame 1 to input frame 10 and output frame 1 to output frame 10. Each one is of 100 incoming lines and 100 outgoing lines. 4-stage switching network is having 4 different stages, primary stage, secondary stage, tertiary stage and 4th stage. The interconnection between primary and secondary is called as A-link and 3rd stage and the 4th stage is called as the C-link. Interconnection between secondary stage to tertiary stage is via the junctors. And the interconnection is as shown in the figure. The cross point calculation for 4-stage switching network, the number of primary switches is equal to 100, the number of secondary stage switches is equal to 100. Similarly, tertiary stage for 4th stage is also 100. Total number of switches is equal to 400. The cross point per switch is 20. Hence, the total cross points required in the 4-stage switching network is equal to 8000. The 400 switches into 20 cross points, that is equal to 8000 cross points. The reference textbook used here is Telecommunication and Switching, Traffic and Network by J.E. Flatt, Pearson Education 2002. Thank you.